yellow on the bed.
Coulda died, sickle cell left me traumatized. On that corner homicide, too many mamas cry. He ain't spin that blocky pussy when he seen his cousin die. I'ma lock myself up in the stew, hop out the freshest cars. Man, this shit is changing, I was down, you ain't give me none. I done raised the score, put a paddock on my own. Acting like you know us, my nigga, where you know me from? 100 in my jeans, if not nigga, I keep 50 on me. Call my son on FaceTime, I know my boy is waiting on me. I done seen so much shit, my nigga feel like I can't take no more. My mama called my phone. She hear it in my voice that her son ain't waiting no more. I cannot wait no more. I cannot wait no more. I cannot wait no more. I done seen so much shit, my nigga. I just felt all the pain. I can't take no more.
Yeah. You're now tuned into me. $1 million worth of game on Wallow 267. Right here is Gillet Enough. Right here we got a guest host, Amira Jones. Listen, how you say Amira? Is Amira Jones?
It's Amira's Jones.
Amira's Jones.
Yeah.
That's some Philly shit. Jones is some Philly shit.
Yeah.
But yeah, that song of the week
Amira's
is
Amira's Jones. Who's your Jones?
No, it's supposed to. All right, so it used to be my first and last name, but I felt it was too much of my government out there. So then I changed it to Amira's Jones, like Amira's Instagram. But then it. Nobody,
That's deep. But listen, that song of the week is brought to you by Sean Sloan, man. Wait no more, man. Listen, man.
Shout out to Sean Sloan, man. I see your movement going on, brother.
This episode right here is brought to you, first of all, it's presented by Barstool Sports, but one of our sponsors, shout out to the sponsor, Death Wish Coffee. Mm. See, one thing about it, you got to have a death wish to drink this, right? You know what I mean? But you don't have to have a death wish because I don't got one. I want to live, but listen, man, one thing about it that I like is different flavors, different times. You know, you get it in a bad kind. You get the bag, you get the beans, you get it ground.
You get anywhere
like
you want.
You get that cold brew. Listen, that's slightly sweet. And it's like.
And it wakes you up, huh? So that means he's gonna be wired.
Super amped.
One thing about it, one thing about it, it wakes you up. I ain't gonna tell you all the cheat code, how you amped up, you know what I mean? You know, all type of, you know, but it's definitely. Death Wish Coffee is definitely good. One thing about it, listen, it got a bold, listen, it's smooth, it's bold taste. Mm-hmm. Death Wish Coffee will wake you up and it'll help you get ready to take on the day.
Maximize your day.
It'll maximize your day. Subscribe and save 10% on coffee that's shipped right to your door when you want it. Think about that. It's shipped right to your door. You ain't got to, when you're in the market or whatever, you ain't got to go to, it's shipped right to you. It's just like,
right,
you know,
you.
I'm chilling, it's shipped right to you. And listen, one thing about it, we want to help you get your coffee game up because right now it's pretty weak. You know what I mean? It's really pretty weak. When you go to deathwishcoffee.com/game, right? You go to deathwishcoffee.com/game. You can enter to win a MacBook Pro, Death Wish Coffee Brew, Barstool Sports merchandise, and a year worth of Death Wish Coffee.
Mm. Hold on, a year's worth?
A year worth of Death Wish Coffee, but the MacBook Pro is what I'm talking about.
You know, Toot love this, man.
Yeah, I know. she be killing it. You know what I'm saying? Keep hitting me up. What do you got anymore? Oh, you're not going to kill my stash.
Hey, she be like, you know, we get on a late night.
I'm like, you ain't going to kill my stash.
I'm tired. I'm tired. I go right downstairs.
Listen, I called him to the office.
Come on, you ain't tired no more.
I called him to the office.
Wake up, boo boo.
Death Wish send Toot her own stuff. She's not going to air my brewski out. Right. Yeah, but once again, man, listen, deathwishcoffee.com/game. If you're looking for some coffee ASAP, you can also receive 15% on your entire purchase with promo code GAME. Check it out now. Yeah, but let's get into this.
I would have took a sip of this, but you already put your lips on there, and I don't got no Death Wish. All them, you know, you be home eating April Button.
Oh, that's
that
too much information. That's TMI. I don't know what you're talking about, but that's another story.
So I don't think that's I can pop story, this man. After you. You know what I mean?
Do what you got to do, buddy.
It smell like coffee.
Oh, come on.
It smell like coffee mixed with a little button right now.
Touching my stuff, man.
Hey, listen, man. Shout out to Death Wish Coffee, man. That's really the shit right now.
Let's get into it, baby.
Wakes you up, helps you maximize your day. Let me ask you a question, both of y'all. What would y'all say is the top five things that people are doing right now on social media for likes?
Oh, number one, like we said, capping. Just fantasy life.
Make sure you talk into the mic a little
bit.
Yeah.
Just like a whole fantasy life. Like, you know, everybody's life is so perfect. Nobody repeats their clothes. Mm-hmm. Everything is brand new every single time. Everybody's popping tags. Just a perfect
you
life.
Fantasy life.
Yeah, fantasy life. Like, I don't know, like, it's almost like what Drake said, like, taking pictures on vacation, but you keep them in a tuck.
Mm-hmm.
So then, for like, 4 months from now, you put out these vacation pics, you make it seem like you just was on a trip again.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, like, I'm all about projecting your best life, because I believe in manifestation. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. What you put out, you won't get it back, and you claim it, you could get it.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes, it's just, like, people be lying. Just, like, just lying.
With me, I think, you know, I seen a video, right, where a guy, he's in the car, he got his phone out, he's, woman's on the side of him, and he like, yeah, you know, I just hit that nigga up, he was talking that shit, I just shot that nigga, yeah, shot him 4 times.
He was recording it, or he was on the gram?
No, he's recording it live, he's on his Instagram live. Yeah, fuck they thought, you feel what I'm saying? Yeah, fuck the, yeah, talking that shit. His girl like, yeah, you did that, yeah. He like, yeah, hold on, think of the cops, they riding by. Babe, tell me if they turn around, babe. You feel what I'm saying? Like, she like, oh, they turn around. He like, if they pull up on us, I'm just getting out and running. All this is on live. She like, oh, babe, they turn around. Get out. He jump out the car. He start running. Next thing you know, the cops is on him. Freeze! He drop his phone on the ground. He got his hands up. Now, this nigga just said he just committed probably attempted murder if the man didn't die. He's promoting it on live. Why, the police got the guns on him. He got his hands in the air, but what'd I do? But he peeking down at the ground, looking at his Instagram, trying to see how many followers there. What'd I do? I ain't do nothing with y'all. They get on the ground.
He's still worrying about the gram as he ready to go to jail.
And I'm looking at this and I'm like, this gotta be the craziest shit I ever seen in my life, man. And it's just like, you see all these guys who supposed to be street niggas, but they ratting on themselves. Let me tell you something. If you in the streets and you a goon, you a goblin, and you telling on yourself, you's a rat goon. You ain't a raccoon, you a rat goon. You a goon and a rat at the same time. You's a rat goon. They might as well just put the little joints on your eyes, because just like a raccoon, because, like, how the fuck can you do something illegal and then get on social media and tell motherfuckers I'm doing shit illegal?
But that's the wave. Like, everybody got, you know, put the guns and the money, everything right there and talk about it.
But, okay, you got youngins who, okay, they live in the facade on that type of time for their so-called image. You know, because we from a place where everybody do what everybody do.
Mm-hmm.
But the difference between us is we ain't everybody.
Fuck no.
You feel what I'm saying? So it's like, if you in the streets, what year? I'm a old school nigga. But what year did it come into effect when it was like, okay, now we gonna start snitching on ourselves?
Let's start advertising our crime.
You know what? I think it happened. I think it was when social media got big, because you got your own platform. It's almost like the guys who can't rap, right? Because rappers tell their story about these fantastic crimes and heists they pulled off, and they could tell it, and you don't know if it's fantasy or fiction, and they could be like, oh yeah, on the low, it's real. But these guys, they're like, I can't rap, but let me get that notoriety that they have. So I'm gonna have to really, really go in. I'm gonna try to show it in real time. Because it's like Nicky Barnes, like big gangsters, we heard about it later, right?
Mm-hmm.
But they want the love in real time. They want the fame.
Right.
Even if they ain't got the money.
I just shot a nigga. Right. Look at me. I'm a gangster.
Ooh.
Yeah, they want
money.
It,
look at it. It's right here.
Right. Yeah. But then the flip side is that is niggas get locked up and then be up to jail crying themselves to sleep at night.
Yeah.
But this what you asked for, nigga. You wanted to be a BET special.
On the next American Gangster.
Right. Yep. You wanted to, that. This is what you was. So now that you're caught, don't do no bitching. Don't do no faking and frauding. Don't be calling home trying to have niggas throw fish fries and shit. Oh, now you want to throw a fish fry. You a gangster.
Listen.
Gangsters don't throw fish fries.
This is the thing. I get a lot of calls from people, especially young cats that I done ran across out here. They people might call me, what's the name on the phone? And everybody want to talk to me. Damn, wow. I'm like, hold up. Because I know one thing, when Wild O 267 was Wild O, and I was married to the streets of Philadelphia, got locked up like a month. I got locked up so many times, I always signed up for my time. I was cool with it.
Right.
Oh, yeah. I'm doing crime. Let me do. Everybody, I want to get. Oh, shut the fuck up. This is a part of the game. I don't want to hear no bitching from no street niggas.
Right.
Hello.
I ain't call home. Have a fish fry for me. Raise some money. No, I did my fucking time.
Right.
Like that was my whole joint. So it'd be like it'd just be crazy. It's like a motherfucker come through. You shot the whole neighborhood up. Little shoot 'em up.
Right.
Now you tell me some man. I'm trying to get out. Niggas left me hanging. No. If you out here and you operating outside of the law and you a real, quote unquote, street nigga, please don't be calling home, burning your mom out.
Right.
Please don't be calling home, worrying about baby leg when he piping the shit out of your baby mom. Right. Now. Don't be, listen, your baby mom, listen, when you in the street, this let me just tell you this. When you in the street gang, your baby mom or your chick, you're basically putting them up for auction, like advertising them. Mm. You know what I mean? On some real shit. You
25,
basically,
30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50,
50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, listen, you basically advertising because what's going to happen is you got that one boy that been liking that picture all that time. He waiting. That nigga waiting. The boy that worked for the UPS, the nice boy every time he comes to the crib because he always ordering stuff. Mm-hmm. Hey, how you doing? Yeah, hey, hey, how you doing? He can't wait because he following you on the low. He can't wait till you put that free Raheem, free my baby daddy. Because
you know why?
He going to blitz the shit out of you. Yeah. The next package that he coming, It might have a surprise package after the package. And I'm talking about, he going to come with the package, and he going to leave a package, which is the semen. And the next thing you know, a package going to jump up, and you going to be in the joint, and your mom going to tell you, you know Nene pregnant. What? By who?
Like, but I've been going so long, Let me just say this.
I don't know what the fuck he just was saying about all the packages and shit. He confused me. Let me break it down. Let me break it down to y'all in simpler form what Wallow was trying to say. He going to go from liking your pic to spiking your bitch.
Yep.
That's what he's saying. He gonna go from liking her pics to spiking your bitch. Soon as you go to jail, soon as you get my opportunity, they gonna blitz your bitch like it's 4th and Inches, ball on the goal line. 59's the mic, blue 32, Omaha. What's the safety? Yeah, he's blitzing your bitch.
And you know what's gonna happen.
So you better know the right protection. So you can seal up the offensive line, or a nigga gonna sack your bitch like Lawrence right Taylor back in the day when he was right snorting that yo.
Is to get out the motherfucking game. Yeah. Is to get out the streets because the streets.
I mean, because any game, there's rules to it, right? Whether basketball, spades, it's rules.
Checkers.
And there's shit that come along with it. And you cannot cry if you lose.
Listen, hold up. Talk news
heavy.
Flash.
Talk heavy.
News flash, I gotta say this. News flash, dear street operators, right? Everybody out there in the streets, I'm not trying to scare you or none of that. But they're street operators. Everybody out there operating outside of the law. I just want to let you know, somebody sitting on your couch, the couches you pay for, when your son running around playing on their lap now, you know what I mean, playing games with him, somebody going to be doing that because you know what? That's a part of the side effects of the street game. Mm-hmm. See, the side effects of the street game is you're going to be sitting in that cell and your homies, they going to forget about you. Somebody else going to come up on the block. All that shit what you did. Yeah, I was the man out there. No, you're not going to be the man for 5 to 10 years or 10 to 20. And some of you niggas is life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So the side effects of being a street nigga is there's a not a strong, there's a guarantee. And this is a part of the guarantee. This is a guarantee within the contract and the fine print of the street game of the side effects. The guarantee side effects is somebody going to be blazing your broad. And most of the time it's going to be somebody you know. They're going to be blazing the shit out of her.
Cooking your bitch beans.
They're going to be blazing her.
Baking your bitch potatoes.
And your son and little boo-boo.
He going to hear her. He going to hear your man and they eating your bitch ass potatoes. Not mashed potatoes. He going to be eating your bitch ass potatoes.
Listen, you know how many dudes I've been with in the joint and they just be mad as shit? They walk around mad all the time because somebody gave them that news. Mm-hmm. Somebody done told them.
I'm going to keep it all the way real, though. You know firsthand.
Fuck you mean?
You went to jail.
Oh yeah, yeah, it happened to me.
We know what's spiking your bitch.
It happened to me. Listen.
You know firsthand.
Listen.
Nigga was spiking your bitch. He called me going around there.
You know who told me? You know who
fuck around there?
You know who told me?
Fuck you talking about, nigga? You got fucking 20 years. You think I'm going around there checking on your bitch? I ain't expect a gadget.
You know who told me that?
You talking about go gadget eyes? Oh yeah, that is mama. That is baby league walking in there. I wasn't even gonna give that information.
You know who gave me the game? Rock the World. Listen, he said it so smoothly in the rap, like it was just normal. Yeah, what's his name? You know he fucked. What's his name? I'm like, I didn't even know this shit. I'm like, what the
fuck? He killed you. Hold on. So hold on. For everybody that's listening, when that nigga slid that through there, yeah, you know he pistol beat your bitch with his dick. Yeah, yeah. But anyway,
just imagine.
Well, how did your heart drop?
No, it was like this. It was like this. It was just imagine somebody shaving my head with a razor blade, and they just doing like this.
Damn.
Real calm. It was like.
So he gave it to you like this. Yeah, what's up, bro?
Listen, you gotta play it cool.
So say we ain't gonna say nobody who your chick's names was and nothing. But just say if your chick name was Tanya. So he's just like, yeah. So what you up to? No, you know you, because every time you call him from jail, it almost sounded like you was at camp. You know, man, just grooving and smoothing. You know all his old extra,
all the cool shit.
All the cool shit. You know, well, it's one thing about Lowe. He keep. You know, I'd rather be a lion for a day than a sheep for 100 years.
I ain't tell you no dumb shit like
you
that.
Talk about.
Like, I was annoying that time. I was a nigga that listen on anything I love. He'll tell you this. I was a boy that called from jail and I asked a million questions about what's going on.
You did, but you always had some shit. You always had
Mirror, you know, Mirror, no. Oh,
nigga, yeah. You always had some slick shit to say. It ain't nothing. I'm just knee high to a peasant and on a bird. What the fuck are you talking about, Lowe?
What happened is when you in jail, right? There's no bullshit. You catch all these sayings that just sound cool but really don't mean nothing.
Right, because you used to call home and say, you know, because, you know, back when we was knee high to a butterfly.
But did I ever,
Knee high to a butterfly. The fuck is that?
Did I ever call home on some deep shit?
No, you never call home on no super nut shit. Like, but that's you always just was trying to talk fly, but you just sounded outdated and shit. Because you was in the pen, you know what I'm saying?
No, that's the old, because I only deal with old heads in jail.
Oh, okay. So you was talking that 1964 shit Martin Luther King and it was saying, when I was knee high to a butterfly.
See, no, I was confused. No. I might say some shit like that. I get on the phone with him, right? This and the third. He be like, so we get to talking. He be this rap. He be like, damn, so what's going on, man? How they treat you, man? They ain't fucking you up there. Let me tell him, like, the system. No, man, it's a brain robbery, not a train robbery. I'm just walking.
There you go.
The thing about me is this. One thing about me, I chose this journey. The journey ain't choose me.
But yeah, all that dumb ass shit. That's how I used to be talking.
Like, listen, I chose this journey. The journey ain't choose
that's
me.
How, hey, let's, you do so, what I'm saying? So let's get back to this. The top five things people do for likes. Capping.
Yeah.
They the fake tough shit on Instagram.
Fake beat.
They're exposing of themselves.
Ho! Getting butt naked.
Oh, yeah.
Butt naked is one of the top Jones on Instagram. For likes, getting ass naked. Ass Absolutely. Naked is one of the major Absolutely. Jones.
I'm going to keep it all the way real. I'm just going to keep it all the way real, man. Is it me? Or do all these bitches got the same bodies and the same clothes from Fashion Nova?
Oh, definitely.
I'm tired of seeing you bitches with the same bodies in the same fucking Fashion Nova fits, man. Like, this shit's getting the fuck out of control, man. Like, this shit is getting out of control, man. Like, you almost think you like that shit. And then now that shit's so oversaturated.
So what the
that,
fuck you want to see then? You let me know. What you on the other team now?
It's not about what I want to see, but it's just like, damn, like, it's almost like nobody ain't got confidence in. It's like nobody ain't, like, it's just like everybody got the same body. Like, and they take it too far, Lowe. Like, at least get your shit proportioned right. Tell like, how your motherfucking calves that skinny and your ass that big, man?
Tell it to tell
bitch
it.
got calves of a 117-pound bitch, but her ass is of a 180-pound bitch.
I wasn't educated on that. Like, it really meant something.
The bitch got big ass on some stilts, man. The bitch got an oversized ass on a pair of Slim Jims. No, rip it to a Slim Jim.
They be saying, like, when your ass and your thighs don't match.
Right.
But
like,
at
least match your shit up. Like, if you a slim girl.
So you won't tell somebody. They
just get a little slim little bubble.
So you
ain't got to get a big ass bubble. Your bitch, some of these bitches.
You want somebody to get ankle surgery? So they got to get their ass in the ankles when they play NBA?
No.
What they on the court doing?
Let me tell you something. These bitches need their ankles and their calves done. And they need to take some fat out their back and put in their fucking calves too, if you gonna make your fucking ass that fat, man. Like, bitch, you don't realize that you look like a fucking ant. You're running around here like a human ant, bitch. Like, I have no problem. Listen, I have no problem with. It's just so many. And I'm not gonna say it's some women out here who they go get their shit done and it's done right.
It's nice.
They real make nice. Sure their shit is done. They don't overdo it. They not over. It's too many bitches that's overdoing it, man. And it's like, damn, bitch, it's like, bitch, your waist this big, bitch. You're starving. Bitch, you look like you're fucking about to die. Like, and your ass is this big. Like, it's just like, that shit is disgusting, man.
I mean,
and
somebody
it's starting
like
to look
it.
Nasty, man. It's like, it's starting to look nasty, man. Like, damn. Like, some of you bitches should have went back to the surfboard with the fucking little crack in the middle, man.
So you want them to have a flat shitter?
Hey, listen.
You want they shitter to be flat.
Let me tell you
long
something.
Back.
Let me tell you something. At the end of the day, bro, it's like, yes, over some of them bitches, yes, they would take the surfboard with the crack in the middle over that nasty ass bubble that you got two basketballs sitting on two Slim Jims, man. That shit's not matching up, bro. So at the end of the day, they get naked. Mm-hmm. They capping on the gram. The fake tough shit exposing them. They rat goons. Okay, so they rat goons. That's one. They snitch on themselves. Yeah. They rats and they goons. Just for likes. Right, just for likes, right? They get naked, right? They capping.
Fake beef.
Fake beef.
Fake beef.
Yeah, fake beef.
And what's number five?
No, not fake beef, organized beef. They be organizing the beef, orchestrating it like it's beef so people could believe it.
Niggas be out here hustling beef for likes, man.
Yeah, hustling
beef. I mean, you know what? That's true, because some people, the captions, every caption they got is about who hating on them, who mad at them, or are you mad at me? And I'd be like, who are you talking to? Who's mad at you? Yeah. What's going on? Like, that is true, fake beef.
I mean, that's imaginary beef.
Imaginary beef, yeah. Right?
That's different. Imaginary beef is that you're beefing with somebody and you're a vegetarian, and they don't
vegan
know that
beef.
You're beefing with them, and you don't deal with meat because you know how to, you know what I'm talking about. But go ahead.
Imaginary beef.
Imaginary beef.
Hey, listen, man. Let's get into it. We don't even got five. What's the top five? What's the last one?
I don't know. I was just thinking about the naked part. Do you feel like since quarantine, it's been a lot more of it? Because I seen the virtual strip club on Instagram.
Well, I feel like since quarantine, it's been a lot less because these bitches ain't right. These bitches feet crusty. These bitches toenails.
They got a photo gallery. They throwing old shit up.
Oh yeah.
No, but I'm talking about new shit. These bitches that fuck all the throwback Thursdays that niggas already seen and all that. I think it's been less, honestly, on the gram because these bitches busting and disgusted right now. For real. Bitches hair ain't done. They feet rusty and crusty. You know what I'm saying? Bitches done sat in the house over the last couple months, ain't had nowhere to go. Bitches done put on 30 pounds. Yeah, I mean, some bitches around here looking like a stuffed vacuum bag just because of quarantine. Yeah. I'm just keeping it real. Bitch look like a bag of ice banged up against a tree all because of quarantine. You feel what I'm saying? So fuck it. I guess those are the top things that people do for likes. Okay, let's get into our second sponsor, Manscaped. Okay, let's get into our second sponsor, Manscaped.
One thing about Manscaped is like this. You're going to hook somebody up with the Lawnmower 3.0. See, one thing
so
about
you
the
you give a guy that?
It's for, listen, first of all, it's April is basically, I'm going to say, nut cancer awareness.
Testicular, man.
Testicular cancer.
Right, that wasn't none of them books you was reading.
What, in jail?
Yeah.
It's just a pronunciation. I don't know how to, like, to pronounce it. Like,
oh,
probably.
Okay.
Testicular.
Testicular cancer.
Listen, it's testicular. Testicular.
This is how I used to read in school, y'all. Just for the record. This is just how I used to read in school. Wallace, could you read that?
No, you're lying. Now you know how you lying?
Testiculus.
I'm going to just say this.
Testiculus.
I'm going to say this.
Cancers.
This how you lying.
Be from. That's how I used to read in school, y'all. So go ahead.
Testicular.
Yeah.
Testicular Cancer Awareness Month, right? Now listen, that's what I'm saying.
Fucking school, that's how you read.
But I'm going to just say this though, on some real shit to take it back. I didn't know how to read when I was in school. And every time the teacher would come close to me when I was younger, I would always go to the bathroom. Mm-hmm. Until one day when I was in the juvenile facility and I wanted to read this Yo magazine with Eazy-E on there. Mm-hmm. I actually went to the school and told the lady, could you help me? I want to learn how to read. Just because I wanted to learn to read that magazine. And
so the only reason why you learned how to read was because of Eazy-E?
Shout out to Eazy-E. Rest in peace. Eazy-E was a legend. Yeah.
Damn, if Eazy-E ain't never had that magazine out, you'd be,
I probably don't,
you be in the restaurant right now ordering scrimp Lamborghini. Can I get some scrimp Lamborghini?
What? Yeah.
They like, bitch, like what?
Because I do like shrimps and Lamborghinis.
Can I get some scrimp Lamborghini? Bitch, like what? You mean shrimp linguine? Oh, yeah. Give me some shrimp.
Listen,
shrimp Lamborghini.
At the end of the day, you know what's so shocking? I was in jail with a lot of people, and people don't understand. In this world, I had a lot of guys tell me, man, that I was writing letters for in jail and all that stuff, that couldn't read and none of that stuff.
You know they were some dumb motherfuckers that keep writing letters.
Now, you tripping. I'm a hell of a writer. But what happened is, a lot of people, just because you...
Baby, I can't wait
just because you get paper...
So I get home and you make me that shrimp Lamborghini.
You got a lot of business people and all of that don't know how to read.
Absolutely.
I done ran it. You got business people.
No, R. Kelly can't read or write.
Indeed.
You got a lot of people. So, but once again, it's, you know, cancer, you know, ball cancer awareness month. Right here, the lawnmower 3.0. One thing I like about it, it got the light on, the LED light. So when you shaving down there and you cleaning it up for your woman and for that special moment, because it got to be clean if it's going to be special. If it's not clean, it's really not special. Could you say that?
No,
if you
got to think my dick special and it ain't clean, but no, I understand what you're saying.
But that's another story.
Ain't nobody. I'm going to give it a lawnmower one time just to see what. Matter of fact, you ain't got to get nobody. I'm taking that joint.
No, I'm not giving you. No, don't touch nothing. Don't take nothing from me like that. I don't want you to take this from talking about you gonna hook. No. I ain't. Listen, that's another story. But one thing about this man that I love about this thing, like I actually broke one. I had two. You know what I mean? Because I was using it so much.
What?
I was clean. Yeah, I cleaned it up. I clean up everything. So one thing about this thing is, we save balls, right? That's the name of the awareness. I'm talking about the Cancer Society, man. The Testicular Cancer Society spreading awareness for men's health. You see what I'm saying? And they got this thing going on called. We Save Balls. So I think y'all need to really check that out. The Lawnmower 3.0 is the, you know, and also they got the crop.
There you go. You want me to read this shit?
No, I don't want you to read it. It's just that every time I say something about it, you got to say, you go in your bag because.
It's just for the record, he saves balls.
No, I ain't saying nothing.
You
say
threw we in there,
balls.
Nigga. We ain't, that's balls. Plural. Right,
listen.
Listen, talking a singular form.
They got the crop revisor. I'm talking about all type of stuff. It's a spray. It's a ball toner and a refresher. That's the thing I like about this. That's the thing I like about
you
Manscaped.
You like refreshing the balls, huh?
Yes, absolutely. That's the thing I like about Manscaped. But one thing about it is like join Manscaped Movement and start taking care of your balls today. Get 20% off and free shipping. You know what I mean? With the code GAME, when you use at manscaped.com, always use the right tools for the job. Pop crazy shit. And one thing about it is learn more about the testicular cancer screening at manscaped.com. We save balls, right?
We save balls.
We/save/balls and share educational videos that help save lives in balls. You can save lives in balls. So what I want you to do is copy and paste and send it to people on your phone. You can also get 20% off and free shipping with the code GAME at Manscaped. That 20% off at manscaped.com with the promo GAME. Your balls will thank you later. You see what I'm saying?
Let me see. No, I'm taking this joint. You know, we laugh and joke, but this is the shit right here. Yeah. Like, and if you want to, and you know, stay up on your hygiene, you know, make sure you get Manscaped. This is the shit. I'm taking this right here. So let me talk about something before we get into the next topic, right? I told people that, you know, we was going to give different people opportunity to come on the show, and you know. And we was going to let the fans pick, you know, who they think should stick around. And we brought White Girl on the show. And unfortunately, I love Don't Call Me White Girl, but she's extremely unprofessional. You know, we shot 4 shows. She showed up late every time, which is like, we business people. So for the people that's like, oh, where's Don't Call Me White Girl this week? Y'all should go in Don't Call Me White Girl's DM and let her know that she needs to step her professionalism up because she's slipping like a bad transmission on an icy fucking road. And let me tell you something about life. God don't give you too many chances to be great. So when he give you a fucking opportunity to be great, you best take advantage of it. So, you know. I told her I'm gonna grind your ass up tomorrow, and I'm pretty sure when you watching when the show came on, you was like, oh, they forgot about me. No, the fuck I didn't. You come, you perform, you film for 2 hours, you get paid, you gain 10,000 followers overnight, you gain followers every time we. So not only do we pay you. We put you on a heavy end platform. We help you build your platform so that in a minute you can go do whatever you want. But one thing you're not going to do is you ain't going to take us the fuck for granted. Because niggas get hired and fired every motherfucking day. So this week we have Amira here. And we're going to bring in probably 2 more people and give them an opportunity, and then we're going to let you pick. But the point of me saying this is when God give you an opportunity to be great, you better fucking be great. All right? Don't call me white girl. I'm talking to your ass. When God give you an opportunity to be great, you gotta fucking be great. And don't be fucking calling me at no 12-something in fucking morning talking about you can't make it to some shit that we gotta be at 9 in the morning. All right? Because I ain't the nigga for that. Motherfuckers get hired and fired every fucking day. get your shit together. Is it better to be loved or feared?
Most niggas that be loved, they get killed and shit, man. Mm-hmm. People that be loved, you know, from Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Nipsey Hussle. It's crazy, man. Tupac, Biggie.
So, in hindsight, are you seeing all of these things? Is it in your opinion, is it better to be loved or is it better to be feared?
That's hard.
It's hard because even some people that's feared, a scared motherfucker, kill you.
Yes, indeed.
So it goes, it's real crazy when you want to be somewhere like, it's like, yeah, then it's like, ah. It's a deep drone because I know motherfuckers that have been piece of shit their whole life, vicious motherfuckers, and they still around. Now I know motherfuckers that was loved and if you go to every hood in America, some extraordinary motherfuckers that did good for the hood, that looked out, that did, them be the motherfuckers that a motherfucker kill. They kill them quicker than anything. Mm-hmm. Like you hear about them, boy was a good dude, he's a lookout. They kill, what's the name? Yeah. But that's the reality because that love, you gotta stand, love come with a lot of hate. If a lot of people love Amir, it's gonna be a lot of women that never met in their life that's going to be just mad because of the love that she's receiving. Not that they know her personally, not that she disrespected them, not that, and people envy love so much that it can create a hate and a rage in them. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like a woman be mad at her just because some men that she might be feeling ain't paying her no attention, ain't on her page liking her.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, I don't really know how to touch her. I don't really know where to
hard.
Go with that.
It's a real hard one because you know what? Like when they break it down metaphysically, right? There's two emotions and that's all it is. It's love and fear. Mm-hmm. Hate comes from fear. Anger comes from fear. It's like all those, everything negative is a fear of some sort. So that's really hard because there's beloved figures who we love them and they're here, but you're right. People are very envious because they fear that you getting that shine and that love that they'll never get, or you're overshadowing them. Your shine is bigger. So fear can be really, really, really strong.
I'm going to say,
wow.
On a question of whether I would rather be loved or feared, when I think about that question, I have to say it depends on what point in my life I was at. Mm. When I was in the street robbing niggas, I didn't want to be loved. I wanted to be feared. I wanted them niggas to know when I walk up, like I said in the song, by the time I was 18, I walk up on the corner and none of them niggas stayed long. And I ain't lying, kid. I had that iron cig and my heart fucking bigger than a lion's is. I wanted niggas to, when you walk up, you wanted niggas to get there. Oh, shit. Here come them niggas.
Oh, where the fuck was I at? You walked up on corners and niggas stayed there and talked to us. Ain't nobody.
Get the fuck out of here, nigga.
Ain't nobody fucking leave.
Let me tell you something.
Who the fuck left?
All right.
Everybody, hey, Wild Love, what's up, Gil? What's going on? Where the fuck was I at in jail? When you walked up on the corner, ain't nobody stay long. Right. Everybody was sitting there, motherfuckers, they pass you the 40, pass you the little motherfucking the rope, the turbo. You
hey, turbos, though. Yeah, don't put that on his name. Don't put that on his name.
Gil, you ain't never sprinkle, you ain't never E40 your motherfucking blunt. You ain't never sprinkled me, baby.
You putting E40 on you putting smut on E40?
No, I'm just saying, sprinkle me. You had motherfuckers that sprinkle that motherfucking baby powder on you. You like baby powder.
I ain't
powder.
Never in my life.
You ain't never put no baby
so
powder on you.
So you saying
your
I was Ram squadding it? That's listen, what you saying? Listen,
whatever. You okay. Put baby powder.
Ram squad was sprinkling powder. Me, baby. Fuck
you,
have, you
like them
about.
Baby power blunts. But fuck ain't nobody, talk. Listen, every time we went on the corner, I'm just saying, I don't know what he's talking about. Everybody stayed the whole time.
Nigga, he know what I'm talking about. But at the end of the day, what I'm saying is, I wanted to be feared. I didn't. I wanted the niggas to know, yo, here come them niggas. Yo, them niggas be on angles. Yo, don't gamble with them niggas. All they gonna do if they lose their money, they gonna rob you. I wanted it to be known because I had a fucked up mindset. And to me, being feared was way more popular than being loved. Because, be honest, I ain't know how to love. I ain't have enough self-love in me to give a fuck about being loved. But then you get older and you have kids and you realize that it's more to life, man. Mm-hmm. I got more of a purpose that I'm living for. Like now, I'm at a period in my life where I would rather be loved than feared. You feel what I'm saying? And it's been like this for a long time because I don't give off the "I want you to fear me" energy, all that negative energy that I had back then. You feel what I'm
saying? Yeah, because that time, listen, no bullshit. That time when we fucking robbed that off-duty cop out West Philly, this was back in the day because the statute of limitations is over.
Are
we
you
robbed
sure, off-duty. Nigga, oh, listen, nigga, wait.
Yeah, it's cool.
Nigga,
shut wait. The fuck up, man. I got this. I know this. I was in the Law Librarian jail, nigga. I was in jailhouse, bootleg jailhouse lawyer. Right. I used to be with the old heads that know that shit. Right. Now, listen, statute of limitations, that's over 20, 30 years ago. So we robbed a motherfucking off-duty cop, right? And this is not a Ratgoon. I'm not a Ratgoon. Because I wasn't.
You're a fucking Ratgoon.
And I tell this motherfucker, once we get in the car, I'm not going to say what's with us. We get in the fucking car and I'm like, and I say, this is the first thing I say.
Say who was with us. Literally, he dead. No, I'm not saying. He passed away. R.I.P. my man Al.
No, it was somebody else with us from that up the way. You know what I'm talking about. Ball head.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Listen, so on and so on. I tell this nut, because you did have a little punk ass toughness to you. I say, oh shit, man. Let's get his shit back, man. Because he realized he had a shield and he's joined this off-duty cop. This nigga will hunt us down. Let's get his shit back. He's like, fuck no. Fuck that nigga. I'm like,
yo. But I'm going to keep it all the way real. We see him.
I was like, oh, shit.
We like,
this is a superhero.
We see him.
This is a
good
guy.
We see him. We jump out on him. I whip out on him. Hey, nigga, you know what it is. He say, oh, I'm a cop.
He want an athletic motherfucker.
He say, oh, I'm a cop. I say, nigga, I don't give a fuck what you is. You get on that fucking tree, nigga. So he hugging the tree. We come up off him, anything. Oh, Lord.
I said, I'm like, yo, we got to get this back. We got to do the right
nigga,
thing.
Nigga, run down the street. That nigga haul ass down the street. We jump in the car. We're on the E-way coming from down the bottom playing Nas. I will never forget this. A stolen cop's Glock. What was the song?
I forget.
The stolen cop's Glock with I forget the name.
I wasn't
of the
feeling
song.
The energy right there.
You was bitching. Yeah, I'm you like, was at all time. Oh, we just tried to cop.
I'm just thinking
going,
the time.
I was
like,
going heavy.
We gonna get 100 years.
I was like, yeah, that bitch ass nigga. I'm looking at.
I'm like, we gonna
joint.
Get 100 years.
I'm like, yeah, nigga. We got one of the real joints. Look at this nigga.
I'm like, we gonna get 100 years.
See, and what's so crazy is I was so negative that the shit that was fueling me was like. Imagine when that bitch ass nigga gotta go to work tomorrow and explain why he ain't got his fucking gun. Fucking nut.
And I'm thinking about sitting in the motherfucking cell for 100 years.
Real talk.
Yeah. Because
they're gonna throw all the extra charges on that shit. So I'm thinking about them charges.
So that just go to show y'all that how much a nigga grew up, man.
Mm-hmm.
That we was really that fucking ignorant, man. That we thought. Well, he didn't. He was bitching. But me and the other nigga, we
were always
just,
thinking about shit.
Yeah. That's probably why you went to jail, too, because you had a conscience. You robbed motherfuckers and you feel sorry. Why I did that? I should have did that. I'm dancing. Yeah, nigga, we got motherfucking 4,000. Nigga, goddamn, we just beat that nigga for 5,600. This nigga crying. We should have did that, though, cuz. Stop bitching, nigga. Count this money. All right, I ain't going to give you a motherfucking half.
Think about
all right,
shit.
I ain't bitching.
No, I'm getting my motherfucking money. Fuck is you talking about? You separate mine from yours, nigga. I'm getting my piece. Action.
That's what I'm saying. So, but to the youth out there, man, any one of them dumbass decisions that we made could have put us in a pen. And it's just fortunate for me that God, that wasn't in my plans with God, man. And Wallow used to call home and say, bitch, I don't know how you ducked that shit, bitch. He used to call home, bitch, I don't know how you fucking. How the fuck you still out there, bitch?
I never was bitching.
You no, you wasn't bitching, but
used to ask you certain questions like, yo, you remember, why was you wearing a certain shirt? Because I thought you wore a wire on me that time.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yo.
Because you was wearing certain shirts. I'm like, why you keep wearing a shirt? I think he said, and I'm like, how did they know certain shit? How did they know this move was going to be made?
Fucking liar,
I thought
rat
she was wearing
goon.
A wire, you fucking
you're
rat.
Fucking rat goon. Hey, listen, man. Let me ask y'all. Let's get into this, right? Is it a proper way to slide in a person's DM? And what DMs get your attention?
As a woman.
The DMs that get, I don't know. You know, it's I look at the DM and I always go to their page.
Oh, so if a nigga said, damn, small head, bald head, I want to pull that motherfucker and pop you from the back. You hear me? I want to slap you on your ass and give you the real red bottoms.
I look and be like, what the fuck? And then I look at his page and be like, is he a comedian? What's going on here? And you know what I mean? Uh-huh. But right away, I don't really get offended by a lot of stuff. You know what I mean? Okay. Like, I'm like, whatever. But I look at the page because some guys come with this fantastic, oh, I would love to do X, Y, Z. And then I go to his page and he got, you know, two posts. He follows 8,000 people, got 3 followers. And I'm like, oh, this is some spam. You know what I mean? Right. But I think... simple compliment.
Have a nigga ever baked you out the DM?
Let me think about this.
That, what the fuck you mean? You got to think. You know if a nigga slide in your DM,
you know what?
And y'all
I've met guys definitely through Instagram and Facebook. And I had a whole relationship from Facebook.
How long did it last?
3.5 years.
From a DM?
Yep. Literally DM'd me and was like, I think he's so beautiful, da 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 da, I'm out the country, whatever. We didn't connect until years later. And then that shit was funny. Like, I liked the pic. He wrote something on Facebook and I just liked it. Like, oh, and I like anything just about, if you're having a good time, having a good experience, you feel great. Oh, nice, great. And then he went right in my DM. And then we started dating. He said, I knew you wanted me. I said, what you mean? He said, you liked my post. I said, she on.
That's how we be.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm going to just say this. I'm going to just be straight up. I was a DM slayer before I got my woman, right? He already know. Mm-hmm. He used to say, what you used to say I used to do?
He copy and paste and send it all the bitches.
No, I ain't do that fucking
shit. He wrote a whole joint out, copy and paste, and sent it to 400 bitches.
He lied on me.
On the copy and paste instead of asking, cuz, give me
Gil
some game.
Used to say,
he called me up talking about, cuz, give me some game. I could sell these bitches in the DM.
No, I never said that. You say,
listen, I wrote him a whole joint out, right?
Hey,
he copy and paste and sent it to 400 bitches.
Lying.
And hit me back talking about, yo, they hollering back at me at a rapid rate. I said, like, fuck you expect, listen, nigga? My game
lying.
Platinum in 111 countries.
His favorite
nigga.
Thing was
fuck
this.
You,
his favorite thing was, oh, you out here motivating bitches out their pants.
Yeah, he was motivating bitches out their pants.
That was his whole joint.
He was.
But they used to be in your DM looking for me. And listen,
yeah,
then I look at my
the one little chubby bitch from up the Northeast was in my DM. Let's keep it real, little chubby bitch, built like a little motherfucker, a 94 Honda Prelude. Let's keep, she had a little pretty face, but she is a little goddamn vending machine. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You hit her titty and a coke coming out that ass. You hear me? So let's keep it real. But she was, you must have fucked the leather off her jacket. Because this bitch was in my DM.
This bitch went hot, cold.
She hit me. Gilly, Wallow's not responding to me anymore. Please, Gilly, I know you're a good guy. If you could just holler at him for me. You know what I
mean?
I said, dog, who the fuck is this, bro? Oh, no, that's a bitch, man. I was fucking a bitch, man. Bitch told me she loved me, man. I had to get the fuck out of here. What the fuck? What you mean? Why the fuck you had to? Bitch told me she loved me. I only fucked the bitch twice, man. She wanted to lay on a nigga chest and shit. I ain't with that shit, cuz. I said, what? Now I'm laughing. Yo, okay. Next thing you know, another message come through, right? You know what? Fuck you and Wallow. If he ain't gonna get back at me, then fuck him. He think he just gonna fuck me and disappear. Okay, I'm gonna expose that nigga on the gram. I said, damn, she said she gonna expose you on the gram. He like, I don't give a fuck. I just baked it. I ain't got no fucking woman out here. I don't give a... Another week later, I'm sorry, Gilly. I didn't mean to send you that last message, Gilly. Please just tell Wallow that. I ain't gotta love him. Just come through and just give me some and just... He could just keep it moving.
Now,
I'm like, this
now
bitch
let
is crazy.
Me ask Mirror. Is that side effects of GD?
It is.
That side effects of good dick.
Yeah.
See, so,
dog, make you bipolar.
Did you ever do that to somebody?
I said you fucked the level off of Jack.
Maybe in my younger days.
First of all, your dick is off the market. So why are you trying to throw your dick out there?
No, I'm not putting it out there. I'm just saying.
Yes, she is. Is that the sign of good dick?
I'm asking, did she do that?
He looking at the ladies. I got good dick. Yeah, all right, go home and get stabbed. Go the fuck home and get stabbed.
I ain't saying it like that.
April going to be watching this shit like.
I ain't saying
so
it like that.
You putting your piece in the streets.
I ain't saying that shit.
Huh? You throwing your piece out there on the streets? Huh? He Mirror, just
danger.
For the record, that's the sign of great dick, right? Great dick, ladies. You hear the great dick when it comes.
GD.
That's the GD.
GD.
You better stop playing for you have a fucking knife in your back like a fucking steak at Outback, nigga. You hear me? Shit. But yeah, that bitch was crazy, man. But for guys, the DM is totally different from women. All you got to do is be a nice looking woman or something that's up to par that a nigga feel like he a fuck and he don't give a fuck what you say in the DM. You could just give a nigga eyes. That nigga right at you. What's up with that?
I feel like with guys, you don't even got to write a DM. You just like four of his pics in a row.
That
and
means
he right
more
at
motherfucker.
You.
It's official.
He right at
my
you.
Man told me that when I came home from jail. He said if she liked more than three pictures, she trying to give you some action. So that's like rule. That's like a golden rule.
But see, I don't know if that's the truth, bro.
What?
Because me.
They trying to get your attention.
Okay, but prime example, me. Like Mirror, right?
Mm-hmm.
I know you. I don't come to your page often because I don't never see you on my timeline. So once in a while, you might come across my page. Let me see what Mirror doing. I click on, and because I never come on your page, I might like seven pictures.
But we know each other, and it's different because we already know each other. Right. I'm talking with somebody brand new. They hit follow, and then you see 10 in a row. then you might be like, oh, but it depends. Like, if you're a public figure, like you are, you got million, people are going to do that. They're going to look and be like, oh, I like that. I like that. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. But for like the average Joe, that's sometimes, that's, and I'm not saying that that means a woman wants you, but it's all a woman got to do. And then he's sliding right in the DMs. He'll be like, thanks for the love.
So
beautiful.
If you say if a woman like four or more pitches in your DM, she at least wants to give you, I mean, no. Four or more pitches in a row. Four or more pitches in a row.
How many
pitches
they gotta
like? Wait, hold on. If she likes four or more pitches at one time, she is at least trying to give you a hand job.
She's trying to give you
no,
hands.
I'm saying that a
she
man.
She at least trying to give you
no,
a
I'm
hand
saying
job.
A man will interpret it as that. That's what I'm saying. A woman
but
doesn't even
pitches,
have to.
Is it a pitch?
All right, so what if a woman like eight pitches in a row? Is she at least trying to give you a hand job, or is that dick suck worthy?
I don't know, because it's just like you said, they could just be showing love. I just know men, you don't got to do much.
Love?
You don't got to do much to the man. Like, I remember one time, this when I first realized it, I was probably like 16 in the gallery. And I literally was coming, you know, the escalators used to go one going up, one going down. Mm-hmm. A guy was coming up, I was going down, and he looked like somebody I went to middle school with. And I looked at him like, oh, just look at him in his eyes. He said, then I saw him go and start coming down. I got out of there. I was like, I
he
didn't
said,
want
I'm
him.
Going to tackle Nia Long.
Yeah, he said, he said, he was like,
she's like, oh, Nia Long on Friday.
Holly Berry.
She like Nia Long on Friday and shit.
They, I mean, men, all you got to do is like give a man a little attention.
You high, Craig? No, I ain't high.
You got somebody
on
your phone.
I
Black
still
D.
That's
like,
Black De Niro.
Oh, wait.
Look at that, man.
That's
like Black
De Niro.
What type of shit is that?
Hey, listen, man.
That's wild.
I mean, let's get into $1 million worth of game, right? I want to say this to all the youngins out there, because I, you know, if you're an older guy, you could take this advice and run with it as well. But I only speak to the youth, really. I educate the youth. Stop chasing the fame.
And chase the change.
Hello.
Damn, you took that out my mouth.
I used to rap.
Not the
fuck. Still got a little piece.
Stop chasing the fame and chase the change. What you got to understand is, mostly men, we do everything for women. You know what I mean? If it was no women on planet Earth, it probably wouldn't be one fly nigga on planet Earth. Because what the fuck would? Well, it would be some, because you got some men who like men, so they would probably get dressed to deal with them. But niggas wouldn't be fly at all. You feel what I'm saying? Because we ain't got nobody to impress. You feel what I'm saying? So for the guys out there that's doing everything for the women, and all they worrying about is the fame. That's the era we live in right now. You just worrying about the fame. Understand this. When you don't chase bitches and you chase money, when you get money, bitches chase you.
Yeah.
And if you got enough of it, them bitches gonna catch you. You hear me? And they gonna suck your dick like it's never been sucked before. And the money makes you a boss by default, because you are able to provide and do things that most motherfuckers can't do. So niggas chase the fame to get the bitches. When you chase the change, the bitches come to you.
Because we living in the world, like he said, and I'm gonna ask Mira the question after this. We living in the world is you could be anything before money. You could be any type of dude, a nut ass boy. See, money can't unlame a lane.
Absolutely.
Right? But you could be anything out here. If you get money, it's to a point. And I'm gonna ask you a real honest question as a woman. It seems like when you get money, the women don't give a fuck if you was a nut. They don't care about what you look. They just like, he got paper. Is that for a lot of women? Do a lot of women see it? I'm just asking your opinion. I can't speak for it, but do a lot of women see the first thing y'all thinking about? What do y'all see for? Do y'all see a dude character? What's the name? Well, you see this motherfucker got bread. He could pay these motherfucking bills. He could do this. He could do this. He could get a little cool on the side. Like,
and we're not saying when you a young girl, when you 18, when he put some dick on me. I love him so much. He a bum, but I don't care. I'm saying when you get to a status where and women get to that status at all different ages. Some women get to that status at 21, where they like, no, I gotta fuck with a nigga that's doing something. Some women don't get to that status until they fucking 40. They just fuck with bums up until they 40. There's some bitches they just love rumpa bum bums, 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 rumpa bum bums. But to the women who get to that point where they like, I'm only fucking with a nigga that's got something going on. How much does that mean?
I think it means a lot, to be honest. When you think about women and like even having kids, like, you know what I mean? The ideal thing would be you have a baby And then you have some time where you could just be with the baby, right? Well, who's going to pay for the bills and pay for the lifestyle? So people, I think men in our society are more valued based on how much they can provide, what they can bring, even amongst men in their own rankings. Like, well, even, you know, like, there's men who just want to be next to men with money. You know what I mean?
Groupies. Yeah. Big holsters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then, but it, even when you talk about, like, the five people you're around and you become, or, like, the four people you're around, you become the fifth one, people want to be around successful people and people who can provide.
Right.
You know? So women, 100%. I think, especially, like you said, when you're young, women look at maybe looks or something. Right. They wonder, how are the kids going to look?
Right.
But a lot of times this money changes things. It does. Because how he earns sometimes can be a statement on how much he takes himself seriously, how he cares for himself. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like I tell, like, one of my cousins, you know, she talk about the guys and this guy and that. And I would be like, well, what does he have going on for himself? Mm-hmm. I used to be like, how can he care for you? He don't care for himself. Mm-hmm. If he willing to be sitting there sleeping on his aunt's couch, you know what I mean? And not after a setback. I'm talking about, this is a lifestyle. Because everybody is going to, you fall down, you get back up, you know what I mean?
And like lifestyle, he's a basement warrior.
Yeah, like just any, just, no, that's, like, a just, living room that's just a, just living like for an example, okay. You know what I mean? Like if that's what you are, like how do you, if a person doesn't attend to their own welfare, how are they going to attend to the welfare of kids or a partner? Exactly, you know what I mean? So it's like, I think it plays a big, big, big part. See,
I'm at a point in my life where I don't even hang with niggas that don't bring value to what I got going on, and I can't bring value to what they got going on.
It got to be a value exchange. It right. got to be mutually beneficial.
Yeah, we could be friends. We could call. We could kick it. Hey, bleh, but I'm going to keep it all the way real. All the raggedy, smaggedy ass niggas, I've been let them niggas go. I've been redecorated my motherfucking surroundings because I had to smarten up and understand that if you niggas ain't got nothing going on, why the fuck am I hanging with y'all? Because I got a lot of shit going on. And I feel funny walking into these meetings, discussing millions of dollars and life-changing opportunities, and then I leave out of there, and I'm hanging with some raggedy-ass niggas who and you could be a raggedy-ass nigga today and not be a raggedy-ass nigga tomorrow if your mind is right. But if you see, if you hanging with some niggas that's doing some major shit and you not trying to get in where you fit in, you not trying to be in a cut like Neosporin and play your role, because everybody got a team, man. Everything is a team. If you can't figure out a role for you to play, then I don't need you on the motherfucking team. Yeah. We going to either trade you or we gonna cut you. And that's just the point that I'm in my life. Everybody that I hang with, they got to play some type of major role and they got to have something going on. You feel everybody else, B-Rock, he brings something to the table. Pop, he brings something to the table. Wallow, he brings something to the table. Mirror, she's doing her. You feel what I'm saying? And all of the rest of the friends that I got, you have to bring something to the table. And if you don't, then, yeah, we could be homies, but we gonna be homies from a distance.
Mm-hmm.
Because you got the wrong type of energy. Your energy is the energy of a nigga that don't do nothing. So how can we build together? We can't even bounce ideas off each other and try to make some new shit come up. You ain't even coming to a nigga like, yo, listen, bro. Such and such and such and such just opened up a restaurant and is doing really good. You feel what I'm saying? If you guys open up a restaurant and you guys do similar to the same things, but you guys bring this in and make it vegan because vegan, niggas don't have no ideas. They don't bring nothing to the table. They don't. They just hanging around. I don't need no professional motherfucking backwood rollers. I don't need no professional backwood rollers. I roll your weed up. No, I roll my own weed up, nigga. I don't want you putting your spit on my shit, nigga.
Was important is
just
this.
Just was eating ass last night, nigga.
Was important is this.
Had me smoking dookie for real.
You got to get out here. We living in a world where it's though. You got to establish your own traction
right. For
somebody to fuck with
you. Right. A lot of people had this thing of, you my man, I know you, do everything, let me just run off, you join. No, you, what the fuck is you doing? Like, you got to come to yourself in this day and time where we got this phone and we talking about a nigga that, you know, I gave everybody a 20-year head start that was out here. When a dude like me could come home and operate off this, like, you can't even come to me with no bullshit. I don't care who you is. I don't care how long I know you. It's like, yo, like, it's Wallow. Come on, how we gonna do? you know, and then the fake collab shit, let's collab. What is we collabing on?
Right.
Like, a motherfucker got to know how to talk to people playing and say, yo, Gil, man, I'm trying to get a little exposure. Or I'm trying to get, you know, let me do this or that. Like, be for real.
Right.
Stop coming to people with all these cap words of let's collab or let's do this or let's do that. For what, bro? What the fuck do you, like, what right. do you, like, because we living in this world where everybody is chasing this fame so much that they just trying to do fake shit that is leading to more fake shit that's not leading to no bread.
Right.
Yeah. It's like, if you got some traction and you got some shit going on, because I'm going to be straight up with you. It was times where I was doing my journey and Gil would know, because I'm funny motherfucker. I'm like, I got people that's my friends and all we do is laugh together.
Right.
Yeah. It ain't about no money. Like, I call you and we'll just trip off something. You'll send me some, and that's what we do.
Right.
It ain't about no money and none of that. Right. But
they also got like, shit going
they got,
on.
They got their own life going on. They might work in a hotel. They might do whatever.
Right.
But Gil, it was times I called Gil and it was like, when I was going through my phase and going through my journey and trying to come up, it was certain people that was like, and I learned early. I couldn't holler at people because I didn't have no value to bring them. So I just kept doing my own thing until I was able to get the value.
Yep.
Now, once I was able to get the value and I was an asset and not a liability to the culture, I was able to call managers. I was able to see managers and call artists directly. Mm-hmm. And be like, yo, what's up, man? You gonna be in New York? I'm pulling up on you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Wallo, come through. They giving me their numbers. Hit me up while they FaceTime. People that in different, I'm talking about from execs, CEOs, mm-hmm. artists,
mm-hmm.
designers, everybody on because I bring value.
Right.
So when you talking to somebody that got some value out here, bring some value and don't just call somebody talking about an idea. Don't nobody want to hear about your ideas or your problems. They want to see the results.
Right.
And the only time people want to hear about your hardships and your journey, your story, once you made it happen.
Right.
Nobody want to hear no whining, no sob story, I need help, no begging. Stop asking grown men to take care of your fucking responsibilities if you're a grown man out here. Because that looking real fucked up.
Right.
You got a woman, you out here got a woman, or you got a whole situation going on in a relationship, but you relying on another man to put you on or be in a position.
Right.
Put yourself on with your fucking action and move out and create something to add value to yourself, your family, your community, the world, and you're going to be the fuck on.
No, that's real. Like, you know, I work in film. And when I tell you the amount of people who call me and be like, I got an idea for a screenplay. And I'm always like, okay, well where is it at? Did you write it? And they like, no, but I got these ideas and I kind of want to like talk to you about it. Maybe I could find a writer. And I'm like, you haven't even put the pen to the paper. I'm like, do you know how much like things change and morph? I'm like, get started. And people won't get started, but they want you to kind of like start with them or hold their hand when starting.
Mm-hmm.
But like, we got kids.
Right.
I'm like, I've already held the hands.
Mm-hmm.
I done already. And that's a thing too of like, I always tell some of my friends who may be still trying to figure it out. I'm always like, look at my son.
Mm-hmm.
He's working and creating music every single day.
Mm-hmm.
What made him get started? He just made a decision.
Mm-hmm.
Make a decision. Don't wait for somebody else, because there is value, right? We're talking about friends.
Mm-hmm.
And someone being just an ear to listen, someone mm-hmm. to laugh with,
mm-hmm.
someone, you know, as a confidant. There's great value in that. And mm-hmm. they don't have to be in business with you, but don't burn me out, right? Don't, every time I'm talking about my ideas, it's like, oh, I don't know if that could work. Or, oh, what do you, wait a minute, I don't know. It's like.
And it's not that people get burnt out. It's just that when you come with an idea, you got to come with the whole plan.
Yes.
You got to have a business plan, because you got to show a motherfucker, everybody, we should open up a cleaners. We should. It's like, where's the business plan? Where are you going to show me, okay, cleaners make this much, it's going to take this much money to open the cleaners. But in this area, you know, it's so many houses and there's so many rental properties being built and there's so many, so they're going to need this right here in this area right here. I've Googled it. It's only two cleaners in this whole 5 mile. Like, you got to come with some stats that'll make a motherfucker say, well, you know what?
This makes sense.
But you forgetting something that's important.
And even collabing,
what's
though.
That?
You forgetting something that's really important. Dear black businesses, right? When you starting a business, we got to stop thinking of I know we come up in the mom and pop era. Hold on, I got this, Gil. We come up in the mom and pop era where, though, everything is based off of just doing it but not doing it all the way. We want to be respected as a business. I want to be looked at as I'm a business. I'm an entrepreneur. I'm making it happen. When you're establishing a business, make sure you got fucking marketing. You got a marketing budget within your business.
Right.
Stop establishing businesses off, I know such and such, they're going to shout me out. I know such and such, they're going to shout me out. I know such and such, they're going to shout me out. That's called marketing.
Yep.
A company, when they establish, they got marketing where they pay people to advertise for their company. They got marketing dollars to put in the paper, to get on the bus, to be on the new, whatever.
Right.
Make sure you come with a marketing budget and stop trying to base your company off of who you know and putting responsibilities on people that don't even have nothing to do with your business or don't know shit about it.
Right. Like,
what's the name gonna promote me? Stop doing that shit, black people. Right. You wanna start a business, and make sure you going at this shit, all you doing this shit full circle.
Right.
Get a marketing budget.
Right.
Have some money to spend so people can advertise you. Have some money to spend for posters, stickers, t-shirt, whatever, but stop trying to start a business off the hookup.
Right. Yeah. Because what happens is, I'm not going to speak from a white person's standpoint. I'm going to speak from a black person's standpoint. But a lot of black people I know, they come up with great ideas. They start putting their ideas into motion. They make it happen. And then once they make it happen, they like, I opened up my restaurant, but I ain't really getting no traffic. Oh, because you, in your plans, you never had nothing about having marketing money.
Yep.
So yeah, you open up a restaurant, but don't no fucking body know it's there. So how the fuck is people supposed to come?
Yep. Marketing that PR. Get the PR they can get all the journalists to write pieces about your new restaurant.
To all my black and minority people who opening up businesses, please be mindful that you have to have marketing dollars to promote your company or whatever you got going on. Because if not, you like prime example, you got rappers out here who got hot music, but they don't have no money to get to promote, to get their music out there. And they could be triple platinum one day, but don't no fucking body know their music. Ain't nobody gonna never hear their music because they don't know the proper channels to get their shit out there.
I'm gonna correct you on one thing, and I'm gonna correct you on this.
Okay.
We gotta stop saying it because a lot of artists say to themselves, oh, I ain't got no money. If you got designer clothes on, if you get high every day, that's marketing money that you're wasting.
Right.
Because I'm going to tell somebody, if I ain't tell you this, fly is in you, not on you. The same chick you could get with a pair of Balenciagas on, you could get with a pair of Air Maxes on.
If your vernacular is spectacular.
The same chick you could get with some Louis Vuitton, some Balenciaga, some Givenchy shit on, you could get with some Adidas shit on. Mm-hmm. I'm just being straight up.
I mean, you're a walking testimony to that.
Listen.
Your woman got goddamn $400,000 worth of bags, and you ran up on her with some fucking Adidas sweatpants on some nasty Vans.
My Vans wasn't nasty.
Your Vans was nasty as a bitch.
I had a clean pair.
No, they was the dirty soul Vans.
Oh, them my
nigga.
Personal joints. They personal to me. Yeah. Them joints I put a lot of work in.
Yeah.
But I'm going to say this, though. And let me just say this to everybody out here talking this player shit. I'm a player. No. You bored or you ain't caught a player.
Right.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
One thing about it, we talking about character. We talking about going at him with that confidence. You know what I'm saying? Confidence got more women than clothes ever did.
Uh-huh.
Tell
him again, nigga.
You know what I'm saying?
Because I walked up on two to pull their head.
And I'm going to tell you something like this.
Pretty shit. Look, your shit got body. You don't need no fucking Paul Mitchell products. You know what I mean?
And I'm telling you,
when you run your shit, bounce, don't it?
And I'm telling you, it's about communication too. Like, I remember when I was out there on the field, when I was out there willing and dealing, when they used to call me Philadelphia Slim, I slide right up on the situation and I get
for the record, I only heard you call yourself Philadelphia Slim.
Listen, hold up, shut up.
Mary, I never heard no bitches call you.
I slide up on him and I give it to him straight up. Yeah, listen, let's get straight to the point. Hey, Wilder, listen, I heard about you. Listen, baby, they call me Slim, but let me know about you yesterday so I can understand you and help you materialize you tomorrow. You see what I'm saying? Like real live shit.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Because I was getting at them in a way like, listen, when you dealing with these women out here, especially these quote unquote super bad chicks, everybody with these bad chicks they see, them bad chicks come with a lot of motherfucking problems.
Tell them.
A lot of problems.
These niggas be Elvis Presley for a bad bitch.
They went through a lot of shit. And a lot of people out there, when we talking about relationships, stop asking for what you can't deal with. Because the badder they are, the more established they are, they come with a lot of shit. And because a lot of people say, I want this and that, and you hear people complaining, oh man, this, that, third. No, you gotta listen, anything that's so great in life, you're gonna have to work for that. And when you talking about dealing with these women, especially come up from these hood environments, it was a lot of dysfunctional shit that took place. And I'm not saying it, but it was a lot of shit that they was exposed to. It was a lot of hurt, it was a lot of trauma. And a lot of times when you talking about being a man and you talking about being with a woman, a lot of times you gotta understand some shit. You got to be a therapist too.
Mm.
And you got to be a great.
You got to be Dr. Gill.
Listen, you got to be a therapist, and you got to be a great fucking listener, because they're gonna hit you with a lot of shit. Because in order to understand the woman you got and to be able to make her, you know, get her well, you see what I'm saying? Because a lot of times you see a woman just because she look good, she got these clothes, they be having a lot of shit on, they be patching a lot of shit up a lot of times.
So you saying a lot of women look good but don't feel good?
Yeah, they don't feel good. See, because the look is the hook to get you to think everything cool.
Right.
Because we living in a world, like she said, this fantasy world, like everything cool. You dig what I'm saying? So it's like, when they come at you, you got to lay a lot of shit down, and you got to just listen to them, and they're going to tell you their journey. And when they tell you their journey, you'll be able to understand their yesterdays so you can help them materialize their tomorrows. And it's real, you know what I mean? And that's Game from Philadelphia Slim. That need to be a new edition, Philadelphia Slim. Thoughts of Philadelphia Slim. That's another story.
The bootleg pimp.
You know what I mean? No, the bootleg, no,
the bootleg pimp from Allegheny. The thoughts of Philadelphia Slim.
You know what I mean?
See, when I was macking and attacking, you niggas was lacking and snacking. You feel what I'm saying?
No, lacking and slacking, baby. They was lacking and
slacking. No, they was lacking and snacking. They was at the crib just eating all the kids' snacks. That's what I'm talking about. You doing it. You thought I was off when I was on.
Yeah, I know you doing it, baby. You
know what I mean? Jordan, I mean, last dance.
Mac on.
Right. Let's get into this. Let's do this real quick. What's the top five sports gear in hip hop?
You know what? I think on some real stuff, I think this was so good. We should say that to the next episode. We should make them wait. What you think?
Make them wait? All right, well, let's get into this last one, Stories from the Cell.
Let's get into Stories from the Cell. Now, Stories from the Cell is about something that's I'm talking about simplistic. It's simple, right?
Okay.
This is for everybody, and I'm not encouraging that, but I'm gonna say this. Okay, how can I say this? How can I break this down? Some people they're going to jail. I don't want shit for nobody. Mm-hmm. They're going to jail. So my whole thing is, let me tell you about entrepreneurship in jail, right? One thing about it is this. Two things can happen, right? You go to jail. Majority of the time, ain't nobody gonna do nothing for you. So you're gonna be in a situation where as though you fucked up. You need money, right? Mm-hmm. And there's multiple things you could do. You see what I'm saying? I know people that hold people's stuff, hold wine and stuff, let people utilize their cell as a stash spot. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying always illegal. Some people just got people that hold, like they got a store, like, and they might hold stuff in there. So these are the occupations on the underground of jail. Mm-hmm. And I'm not encouraging or promoting, and I'm just letting you know, because the reality is this is a lot of people's future. Mm-hmm. They're going to be in prison. They got to figure out ways to survive in prison. Mm-hmm. And I'm not encouraging or promoting it. Mm-hmm. I'm just talking about what's going on.
You was a poof at one time, right? You got the drugs in your ass, right?
Oh, no.
You was a mule, right? At one time. They told me you was bringing all the weed in your ass, man. All right, go ahead. Finish your story.
Listen, that's some stuff you be into.
I'm just saying, that's what I heard.
But that is a job.
They said, Wallow poofing up here.
A job. Listen, that is an underground job. Poofer. You got a stasher, a person that just, I'm talking about, like, they just hosted. They just a hoster.
Was
they
any of your homies ever a poofer?
No, not that I do.
All right, go ahead.
I don't know. Just that third. So you got that.
So right? where they get the shit out? They ass in your cell? Like a nigga go in the cell, crack his ass open, you pull it out. Like how that work?
I'm gonna explain to you how it work as how it was told to me.
All right. How it was told to him. All right. We ain't judging.
No, I'm not even gonna speak on that because I don't really know. I can't.
How many packs you pulled out the crack?
No,
nigga?
I don't
come
know
on,
nothing
nigga.
About that shit. I'm just saying.
How many packs you pulled out the crack, nigga?
I've never done that shit. I'm just saying.
Why you getting on hype?
No, I'm just saying that.
You know, they usually say when niggas lie, they get, I didn't do that. I mean, I did it once, but I ain't do it. How many packs you pulled out the crack, nigga?
Listen, I ain't even gonna get into that. But listen, all
right, now you just wanna skip it. You just was about to break it down how it go.
No, but I'm gonna break it down how it was told to me.
Or how it was told to you.
But I ain't even gonna get into none of that, right?
All right, go ahead.
You know what I mean? But the whole
niggas should pull packs out of cracks.
The whole shit is an underground of jail is different underground jobs. Like, you know, a lot of people, everybody know my story, they know I was a kitchen warrior.
Yeah.
I was, you know, green peppers and onions, boy. That was one of my favorite grinds. In the joint, you got that. You got people that make cards. You got people that, like, just like you got people out here that's hustling on the street level. Mm-hmm. You got people in jail that's hustling that don't have a physical state job for the jail. Mm-hmm. Everybody from making cards to making, I'm talking about people make, there's some creative motherfuckers in jail that will make things out of anything. I'm talking about you have people that make stingers, sell stingers, you know, stingers to heat your ward up and all that stuff. You got people that take, that make, do-rags. Mm-hmm. You got people. It's so many different jobs. So if you creative and you out here and you doing your
thing. They was in the penitentiary worried about their waves?
What? Listen, you got people. Listen, you got people that make money off of braiding dudes' hair in jail.
You ever braid a nigga hair?
Why would I braid somebody's hair? I don't know how to do that.
All right. I mean, I guess because visits, right?
No, it is visits. So you got poor. I didn't have homeboys. That is true. And I walk in the yard and they sit between somebody.
You know what? I remember.
So some of your niggas was sitting between nigga leg and his hair braid?
Yeah, I checked them. Come on, man.
I remember that when, like, way back, because, you know, me and Wally know each other a long time. Coming to visit Wild one week, and it was this Puerto Rican guy, real good looking. And I was like, wow. And I was like, no, I was just looking like, how was his braid so fresh? And Wild was like,
He gave me some green.
Said people braid each other's hair. He's like, you know, I just, it was on one of those things. But I was just kind of like.
Was he ever laying on the lawn with Sean?
No.
Yo, you know what? Come to ask about you. Then we're going to take the story to sell to that one.
Yeah.
When you used to come to see me in jail, right? How can you describe my energy and how I was feeling? Even though at that time I was fighting the case still.
Yeah.
Like, what was I going through? Like,
you were the same person. And it's funny because when people would ask me when you really came out here, started really, like, you know, your influence started growing, people would be like, is he really like that? Does he really, like, run up on the camera? Because there'd be times where I'd just be home and then you call and you'd be like, Mir, I want you to look at this thing for business. Da, 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 da. And I'd be like, okay. And they'd be like, does he really do that? And I'm like, yo, his energy is the same. I'm like, he was selling T-shirts way back then. Mm-hmm. Like, even I told you, my kid was 2, had on one of Wallo's T-shirts.
Walido's way.
Yep. It was Philadelphia Hustler. Mm-hmm. I was at Russell Simmons' office trying to, like, finesse and get a meeting. It got me a meeting. The girl was like, oh, you from Philly? Me too. Come back. And I was like, oh.
So off the shirt.
Off the shirt. You know what I mean? But legend. Always the same, like, thing. Russell, except Russell, for man. you was a big finesser. You was finessing shit. You'd be like, all right, I'm going to bust this move. We'd be like, wow, I don't know if that shortcut going.
So he's Vanessa Williams?
Yeah. He was, you know, his mind was a criminal. He was still a criminal. Speaking life into people. He'd be like, Mir, you a legend. Y'all had what going on? Y'all got a company. And it's like, before, I'd be like throwing events at nightclubs, and I wasn't old enough to get in yet. Mm-hmm. So it was like, I knew all the owners. And he'd be like, man, you out here doing your thing. And it's like that pump up. Like, we talk about, like, who you surround yourself with. Right. It's important to have friends who speak life into you and see the vision for you.
I think I was speaking more life into other people than I was speaking into myself, because I was still in the street, John. And, like, even with Gil, I'm like, Gil, you the shit. I was the first dude that probably told Gil, like, yo, nigga, you can rap. He's like, man, this shit. I said, no, you can make money off this shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's like, nigga, you trip. I was, come on, we going to the studio. He's like, come on, cuz. Like, what the fuck? You think this? I'm like, nigga, you can fucking rap. Mm-hmm. Like, I never was a dude to hate on nobody of the aspect of, I was always trying to push people to be like, yo, man, you could do that shit, man.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Like, do some next level shit. But mm-hmm. I just didn't know. I ain't never seen it. I always seen, because I grew up in the street culture, that this was the only way. So I understand when young people see it a lot of time. Mm-hmm. That's why I be going so hard trying to tell a dude, like, it costs too much to be a criminal. Because that shit cost me a lot. Mm-hmm. I lost a lot of family. I lost friends. I lost a lot of shit going to jail.
Lost a lot of years.
Lost a lot of years.
That you can never get back.
And you see me. That's why people see me. They be like, wow, I look so hype, man. I'm living my motherfucking life every day because I don't know when I'm going to go. And it's like, to be in that cell for so long, you start appreciating shit so much. And you start thinking like, yo, what the fuck is I'm doing? Why am I? But I was used to being in the cell, because that's my, and it's funny, you see steroid from the cell, but my whole life I spent more time in the cell than I did on the streets. Mm-hmm. And so when I'm out here, I'm just trying to shed light on you. And I know sometimes it might be like, damn, OG, I'm tired of hearing you tell me about don't be in the streets, but what else? Nigga, I'm gonna keep telling you. Right. I don't give a fuck how you feel. I ain't trying to be your homie. I'm trying to give you some, I'm offering game. I'm trying to be a real OG to you. Mm-hmm. I mean, and it ain't no young boy out here that can say, damn, Wild, I was the dude, and you know this, Gil. Mm-hmm. I was the dude that always went and put my own work in. Mm-hmm. Always. I wasn't no dude. I ain't never get nobody no package. I ain't never do nothing. I always put my own fucking work in. If I wanted something, I went and committed that crime for myself. Mm-hmm. I ain't say, oh, I'm on probation. I'm on this. Mm-hmm. Young boy, do this. I was always that dude that'd go step the fuck out there. Because I know at the end of the day, when they lock me up, all right, come on, I'm going to do my time. I already know I got to do this time. Mm-hmm. Nanny, I'm locked up again. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that little couple of hours I got in the box, the sneaker box, take that. And boy, when you going to get it? I don't know, Nanny. One day, I hope so. Mm-hmm. That was my story. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But, you know, at the end of the day, like, you know,
But you always were a real vicious researcher, even back then.
That's my thing.
You used to be like, I saw in this magazine, they're going to say next month it's going to be this person. I need to know his business story.
Once
Easy
taught him how to read, it was over.
It was a wrap. Like, on some real shit.
Easy taught Gil that nigga how to read.
Gil will tell you, Gil and me ain't know nothing about no motherfucking podcast. Mm-mm. We didn't know what it was. We knew that, shout out to Joe Buttons. We knew that Joe Buttons had one.
And Nori.
We knew Joe Buttons and Nori.
Tagstone.
We didn't Tagstone, but we didn't know. You know what I mean? We didn't know.
The value that you could get out of it.
Gil say, we don't know this. I called that nigga. Matter of fact, I pulled him to the crib like 2 days later. I was like, this is what it is, cuz. I had to pay for it. He's like, and I broke that shit down. 1% only get this many downloads. This is that, this is that third. Boom, boom, boom. You got to position it. It's different. It's different. It's different. It's different categories. It's that, boom, boom, boom. Usually they be this long. They got factional pocket. They got this podcast. Right. This thing got this much money for a podcast. Right. You got to get the ad.
And you got to understand that. We're going to end it off with this. You got to understand that it's probably 700,000 podcasts. 750,000 podcasts on Apple alone. We in the top 1%.
We in the 1%. $1 million worth of game.
$1 million worth of game.
And don't get it messed up.
1%.
When all I did was I called Mirror and I said, Mirror, at the beginning, you know how to do a sponsorship deck? Because I'm going to get us some sponsors for this shit. So Gil used to be like, sponsors, what you talking about, cuz? And I just come in. I mean, B-Rock know too. I come right in. Oh, yeah, I got a check. I got sponsors. I'm talking about the first episode dropped, right? And it was only out for 10 hours. I had a $5,000 sponsorship, and I was in Utah. Right. I was in Utah. Gil and them was over here on the East Coast. Mm-hmm. I'm in Utah. I called Gil. I was like, yeah, I got a $5,000 sponsorship already mm-hmm. for one show. And he was like, who? I was like, yeah, he out my man from Texas, a trucking company. Yep. I usually just go get sponsors. Yep. But Mira write the deck. And sometimes we didn't go by the rules of the sponsorship. Nope. They got to be CPMs. We said, no, this is our reach. This is what we're doing socially. We need this much money, boom, boom, boom. And I just went out there and got it. All off of just doing fucking research.
Right.
And that's what it's all about, man.
So, man, we want to thank everybody for tuning in each and every week, man, making us the number one music podcast in the country. You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all go online, barstoolsports.com, get your merch. You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all go, you know, get your, you know, we got a bunch of t-shirts, hoodies.
Hats, everything.
Hats, everything on there. We appreciate y'all supporting. When y'all get y'all merch, man, make sure y'all send it to me on my Instagram in a story or something, or a picture or something, so I can repost y'all and show y'all some love. I like to show love to the people that support us, man. I go by the name of Gilly the King. This is Wallow 267.
Hold up.
No. I go by the name of Gilly the King. This is Officer John Tackle, and this is Amira John.
Amira's John.
Amira's John.
Amira's John.
And Amira, you single?
I am.
Amira could be your John if you.
She could be your John if you. You know, that's another story.
That's another story, but it's just like that.
Right!